Hello everybody, it's Bradley back. Thank you for stopping by on the channel Tripleinc. Today I have a review lined up for you, and this is a very particular review because this fragrance oftentimes gets compared and overshadowed by probably the king of all niche fragrances, Creed Aventus, and the fragrance that I'm going to be reviewing today is Mancera Cedrat Boise. So it's no secret that Aventus is quite successful, and obviously it has spawned a lot of flankers, so many flankers, none more so actually are quite as competitive and that can punch up there with Aventus than this one. While Aventus was released in 2010, this was released in 2011. So I guess a case could be made that Mancera tried to copy the Creed Aventus DNA. I don't really think so, and we'll get into that in my review. So let's really quickly look at the presentation, because you know, if you're comparing this to Creed Aventus, Creed obviously has the cards and the really nice bottles. How does Mancera compare in terms of presentation? We have this box right here. It is indeed a pretty nice looking black box. Has lots of nice details on it as well. And an added bonus when you open it up, like I said, Creed has the cards, Mancera has the pouch game. Really nice looking, sort of a velvet pouch to house the bottle in. Really cool little feature right there. As for the bottle, I really do like this, the look and the feel of this bottle. It has a pretty simple, clean, white label on the front right there. Nice cap. It is indeed a twist-off cap just like that, so you can easily pick it up by the cap, no problems right there. And overall, I really do like the bottle. This is the 2-fluid-ounce 60ml presentation. So with the presentation out of the way, let's get down to the good stuff. How does Mancera Cedrat Boise smell? I always said that this had smelled different than Creed Aventus, especially in the opening. That is when they are most different. Where in Aventus we have the juicy, fruity, tropical pineapple opening, this we have a fruity, lemon, candied, semi-sort of sweet opening, right? This has some mixed fruity notes, mainly lemon is what I pick out, and it is definitely sweeter, has a creamy nature in the opening as well. So this is definitely different off the top from Creed Aventus. Give it a little bit of time to dry down, and what is left underneath is this beautiful, musky, leathery note, which does remind you of Aventus, definitely. I'm not gonna lie, about 20 to 30 minutes in, it does smell very, very similar to Aventus, around 80%, but it still has its differences because this has definitely a little bit more of a sweet tone to it as well. Also, the more this dries down, the brighter and airier it gets, because it is a little bit dense and creamy up top and sweet. However, when it dries down, the cedar note really comes out to the top very nicely. This is super smooth and well blended. While Aventus is a little bit too sharp for my nose at times, this is much better. It's creamier, smoother, while still keeping the very nice natural notes. Also, there is a touch of spices and this really nice woody muskiness that runs out through the entire fragrance, which I find absolutely delectable. Has a very nice dry down as well, and I could say that this definitely compares to the scent of Creed Aventus. Also, Insurrection Pure, I own that one as well. This does have a similarity to that one as well, but it is so different up top because of that really nice candied lemon vibe that it has. Also, some floral touches in here as well. Overall, it smells very, very nice. It is a fresh, fruity scent with a nice, woody, bright backbone to it that will remind you of Aventus, but smells different enough, and I think that's actually a good thing, you know? I think we need to stop comparing all these fragrances to Aventus because Aventus can only be Aventus by itself. This is actually a little bit better, almost in my opinion, than Aventus because I think it is a little bit more complex, definitely not linear. Aventus is very linear to my nose. This has more complexity, definitely more richness, and more depth. So I'm quite happy with the smell of Cedrat Boise. Alright, so let's go into the performance. This is another highlight of this fragrance right here. It does have very nice performance. Actually, it can punch above its weight even with Creed Aventus, and that's the great thing because, you know, with Aventus, you gotta worry about, oh, am I getting the right batch, you know, because they have all these different batch variations. It can be a big hassle to try and find the right one for you. You don't have to worry about that with this. All of these perform very, very good no matter what batch you get. And I think that is a huge positive right there. Longevity, we're talking like 14 hours on the skin. Granted, it's a skin scent by around 6 or 7 hours, but that's still really good. And this is another one where you spray it on your hand and it's like projecting at you from your hand when you first put it on. It has really, really nice projection. It does die down rather quickly, but still it lasts a long, long time, which I do love. The performance is really, really good. That's a definite highlight point of this. Alright, let's continue with the versatility factor. I always thought that Creed Aventus wasn't really signature scent worthy. I know I'm gonna get a lot of flack for that, but that's just my opinion. I never saw that as a all year round signature scent. This is much the same way. I think this works best in the spring months just because it has a very nice natural smell. It smells like nature out here, really, really nice. So I think it works best in the springtime, definitely outdoors as well. Summertime, maybe if it's summer nights or cooler summer days, I wouldn't trust this in the high summer heat because of the creamy nature in the opening. And I guess you could also rock this in the fall because it does have a good enough performance to last in the cooler days. In terms of occasions now, this definitely is not for me a dress-up scent at all. I think fruity scents tend not to be best for dress-up. This has sort of a fun natured vibe to it, which I love. So I wear this outdoors to the night out scenario as well. When I'm out in the clubs, I think it does really good because it has great performance for that as well and smells pretty unique. And this also can work good on a date because this is, after all, a unisex scent. I think it is a little bit more on the masculine side due to that nice musky leather undertone that runs underneath the fragrance. So overall, pretty versatile, but again, it's about the same versatility as you'd expect from Aventus. Let's go with the compliment factor now, guys. So I've been wearing this now for the past several days, and I can say it is a very safe compliment getter. I've gotten about 2 compliments already with it, and I've not come across a person so far that I have let smell it either from the bottle or that has smelled it on me that has disliked it. Every single person has generally had very good things to say about it, so that's really, really good. This is a safe fruity fragrance. I can see it definitely being a crowd pleaser, getting a lot of compliments. And let's come to the value category. This is the big one. Obviously, Aventus is a very, very expensive fragrance, but guess what, guys? You can find a 60ml bottle of this for around $75. Also, you can find 120ml for just over $100. Notino is actually the one who sent this to me. That is an amazing value. It kills it in the value category. This is such an amazing bang for the buck. About a third of the price that you can find Aventus for. That is really, really good, considering that it performs just as good and smells also equally as good. So this is just a no-brainer, such a good value. Okay, now it's time to rate this fragrance. How is Mancera Cedrat Boise going to do? In terms of smell, it gets a solid 4 out of 5. I really always like the Aventus DNA. Smells really, really nice. Come on, wind, give it to me! Woo! Yeah! Windy today, I don't care, I'm still filming out here. 4 out of 5 for the performance category as well. It does perform very, very nicely, very strong, and can easily punch up there with any Aventus batch, doesn't matter what batch you're getting. With the versatility factor, it's gonna score a 3.5. Does good for the warmer months in general. Springtime is the best, I think. Outdoors, night out situation, gets compliments, can also be worn on a date, so pretty good for that category as well. Compliment factor is also gonna score a 3.5 out of 5. Like I said, it is a very safe compliment getter. Doesn't give these crazy over-the-top compliments, but everybody that has tried it seems to have enjoyed it. And lastly, the category that this does the best in is going to be the value category. 5 out of 5, no questions asked. It is an amazing bang for the buck. Super, super good value with this one. So all those considered, I'm going to give this fragrance a 8.5 out of 10 as a final rating. I wouldn't really consider this a Aventus clone. Rather, it's just a fragrance that smells pretty similar to Aventus. I think it does some things better than Aventus does as well, which is absolutely huge. So I think an 8.5 is a very, very good rating for Mancera Cedrat Boise. I was a little skeptical of this one before I tried it, but I'm really, really glad that I did because it is an absolute home run. So I want to thank you again, Notino, for sending this product to me. Guys, stay tuned on my channel. I have a lot of great content coming out for you this spring. The spring is officially here. All the flowers are coming up and everything. I'm really excited to kind of come into this new season of fragrances. So definitely stay tuned and subscribe to my channel so you're updated with all these new videos that I'm coming out with. And as always, have a nice day. Hopefully we'll see you back on my channel soon with another video. Peace.